YouTube. This is actually the second morning after the last clip. I came out yesterday morning and I looked at this and the other parts in here that I had brushed on the rust wash with, and was not impressed at all. Well, as you can see, it's still covered in rust. And I figured, well, before I go and pan this stuff as being a waste of money on camera for the whole world to see, maybe I should read the instructions. So I read the instructions, and it says that you're supposed to soak your parts in it for a minimum of 2 hours. So, I thought about it for a while and then went and did the morning chores and got in and putzed around on the computer for a bit. Then the wife got home from work and we went to the flea market. But, back to this stuff. I came out. I put the extra pieces in this yesterday around 4 o'clock, no, 5 o'clock, and I came out last night to change to flip them over, and I was impressed.
Ooh.
Well, no, that isn't a part of this.
Ooh.
But it was rusty along all the edges. This is a part of something. I think it was actually part of an electric motor lockdown plate. But it's going to be the adjustment on the side of this for the new working table that I have to build for the grinder. Now, you can see where it was allowed to dry in the air, it's got a green hue. But I think that's actually original paint remaining, because on the underside of this we discovered that the original color was sort of an olive green. This is much lighter over here where it was just soaking. And you can see very clearly the line where it did not get submerged. So, I'm going to say that the Rust Check Enviro Rust Wash is worth the money. As a matter of fact, I'm probably going to buy another bottle of it tomorrow so I can soak bigger things. So, ouch.
That one has about an inch and a half band that did not get soaked. Okay, so the downside of it is when you're trying to soak something that is too big and has to be taken out and flipped over. It was soaked up to about here the first time, then turned over, and you can see the line where it was soaked just now. And it is starting to flash rust back. So you need to have enough to completely submerge the part you're working on. And then you need to clean and paint it before it flashes back to rust again. But since we don't have an option to
submerge.
Ah. I'm stuck with having to soak one piece at a time. So, I can't do any assembly right now. You don't need to see me touch these overlap marks up with the wire wheel and spray paint those three parts. So I'll go take care of that off camera, and I will come back when this piece here is ready. I was so impressed with the job that the Rust Check Enviro Rust Wash did on the parts I painted this afternoon, this morning, that I ran into town and bought two more bottles of it. And I have never used the famous other brand, but I have watched lots of guys use it on YouTube. Really, I think this does just as good a job. Although that is completely subjective, because, like I said, I've never tried the other. So this is going to be a regular part of my shop procedures from now on. Just not enough. There is a fair amount of sediment. I think that's a bad thing. It's just noteworthy, I guess. You don't need to watch me dry this and paint it, so not rust, it's just dirt. So, yeah. I would do a commercial for Rust Check Evapo Rust Check Enviro Rust Wash if I could, because
It is now a product that I believe in. So, we'll get that painted and on to the next thing. I bought this benchtop parts washer in the before times. And never really got an opportunity to use it, but I was into Canadian Tire today to get the rust killer stuff, and I asked the guy at the parts counter, let's say kick the tripod, and he recommended. Now, I paid full price for this. This is not a paid promotion. But when I set it up, I did the bolts and washers just to try it out. And they came out fantastic. So we're going to do the rest of the hardware for this. When I was growing up, every parts washer I had ever seen was run with solvents, paint thinner or gasoline or kerosene or naphtha. And these new smaller parts washers a runoff of pond pumps. So they're not compatible with solvent. I'm not in any way endorsing getting your hands into this stuff. I have skin like leather. I can pull poison ivy, handle wild parsnip leaves, I can pull raspberry and blackberry canes out of the ground just by grabbing a hold of their stalk. Oh, look at that. Quarter of an inch thick layer of grinding dust and grease just dissolves away into nothingness. Now, the non-solvent parts cleaner situation is, as I said, very new to me. I read the label in the store and it says to use it full strength. Got it home, plugged this thing in, put the gallon of grease off in it, and it wouldn't pump. This thing requires 2 gallons of liquid in order to be able to use the pump. So this is cut 50-50 with water, and it is still doing an amazing job. What is not coming off here is mostly rust. So these are going to go from here into the rust dissolver. Might be a good idea if you choose to do this kind of thing to be wearing rubber gloves. Go. 2 new products today. 2 recommendations. Considering I'm the one who usually finds fault with everything. I've also never used one of these benchtop parts washers. Most guys I knew made their own parts washers out of old concrete double laundry sinks. This is the King Canada parts washer. I've had it now 3 years, and this is the first time I've used it. The guy I bought it from had no fault with the pressure washer or with the parts washer. But he didn't like the fact it couldn't use solvents. And he bought an older one that would use solvents. And he sold me this for about the same price I saw them when ...15 years ago. So I can also recommend the King Canada Benchtop Parts Washer. That's it for now, and we'll get back to you when we've got further along in this. With my love and leave this life behind.